suffering from knee pain? You probably heard of the term osteoarthritis, but you have also come across the term rheumatoid arthritis. Yet, you are not quite sure what is it. Is it different? Is it dangerous? Or is it curable? You are wondering if you are suffering from rheumatoid arthritis instead. In today's video, I'll break it down for you 10 easy ways how one can easily differentiate between osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis. Let's get on to it. First and foremost, you must know that these are both different diseases. Let's start with what causes it. For OA, it is more of a degeneration of the cartilage of the joints, although recent studies have found that inflammation does play a role too. On the other hand, rheumatoid arthritis is an autoimmune disease. In layman terms, it means your body's own antibody is attacking your joints' tissue, causing inflammation and destruction. The real reason behind it is complicated, and to be honest, like most diseases out there, no one really knows why. Number 2. Age of onset. Both diseases can occur at any age and the risk increases with age, although for RA, it tends to happen in younger people compared to OA. Number 3. The duration of the symptoms. To diagnose RA, symptoms duration of more than 6 weeks give a higher probability of RA, while the duration of symptoms is not a diagnostic criteria doctor use to diagnose OA. Number 4. History of the patient. For OA, one usually will give a history of overusage of joints, for example, a typist, a laborer, or a factory worker who uses their hands a lot. Or you, for example, who is busy smashing the like button on my video now, right? Yay! Or a person who has a history of injury to any particular joint. As compared to RA, RA can happen to anybody with no prior history of joint problems. Do note, both OA and RA have a genetic association. So watch out if any of your family members suffer from this disease, as it means the probability of you having it in the future will be higher. Number 5. The types of joint involvement. Again, both diseases can affect any big or small joint in your body, although OA does tend to favor weight-bearing joint, for example, hips, knee, shoulder, while RA tends to favor smaller joints, for example, fingers and wrists. Number 6. The type of pain. OA pain is what we typically call a mechanical pain. For example, one may feel knee pain while walking or running, as compared to RA pain, which does not necessarily relate to activity and can occur anywhere, anytime. Both can cause stiffness, although stiffness usually favors more towards RA. OA pain will often relieve with rest, while RA pain doesn't. Number 7. Antibody. Because RA is an autoimmune disease, one can find specific antibodies to RA. Rheumatoid factor can be found in 70-80% of the population. Another antibody that is more specific towards RA is known as anticyclic citrullinated peptide antibody. Number 8. Inflammatory markers. Because RA is more of an inflammatory disease compared to OA, one can find higher levels of inflammatory biomarkers, like a raised CRP and ESR in rheumatoid arthritis. Number 9. X-ray differences. The typical findings of RA are bony erosions, whereas in OA, one typically finds bony spurs or what we call osteophytes. And finally, the treatment differences. Both OA and RA respond well to oral and topical analgesics like NSAIDs, as well as intra-articular steroids. But for RA, additional specific treatment is required, known as DMARDs or disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drug, which aims to slow the disease progression. So there you have it, guys. Feel free to drop a comment down below if any of you have any questions, and I'll appreciate if all of you could smash the like button, share, and subscribe for more content like this in the future.